Questions for you. As USNI first reported, China has apparently built mock-ups of the U.S. aircraft carrier and some other warships to practice bombing runs. How concerned is the Pentagon about this? And does this just another sign of escalation of, you know, potential conflicts that with China?
I tell you what we're concerned about, Tara, is the increasing intimidation, coercive behavior of the Chinese military in the Indo-Pacific, and the, also the coercive tactics they are using, even using economic tools around the world to bend other nations to their will or to their view of what's in their best interests. We are in full support of a free and open Indo-Pacific. And we're going to continue to work towards that goal with our network of alliances and partnerships. And again, you've heard the Secretary talk about this many times. He holds the PRC as our number one pacing challenge. And what we're focused on, I mean, I haven't seen these images, and they can speak to what their bombing runs look like. That's for them to speak to. What I can tell you is we're focused on developing the capabilities, the operational concepts, making sure we have the resources and the right strategy in place so that we can deal with the PRC as the number one pacing challenge.
One follow-up and then a separate topic. I mean, but doesn't the Pentagon find it concerning that there's a very active, now visible kind of practicing again, you know, for a potential future conflict? Or do you treat this as just another, maybe it's their version of a tabletop wargaming?
Again, they can speak to their exercises and what they're training against. It's been pretty fairly obvious, and we just released a China military report a week ago that I think makes it very clear what our understanding of their intentions are and their capabilities are and how they're developing those capabilities and to what ends. And clearly, they have invested a lot in particularly air and maritime capabilities that are designed largely to try to prevent the United States from having access to certain areas in the Indo-Pacific. What we're focused on is that pacing challenge and making sure that we maintain the right capabilities and the right operational concepts to meet our security commitments in that part of the world.
One for you on Ukraine.